Hi, everybody. My name is Claude Diamond. I'm the author of The Mentor Teaches the Gut Sales Method. This is a novel, a business novel, and it's based on my experiences of being the world's worst salesperson. And I met somebody who taught me how to sell. And so I wanted to write a novel. So because I think a story tells it better than just another thick academic book. And basically, this is a story about a man down on his luck. And he's blindfolded, he's taken to New York City, spoiler alert, and he's given $20 and he says, now you have everything you need. I've taught you the greatest sales method in the world. Now go out there and sell. And let me just read you a little section from this book, from the chapter. It's called The Gauntlet. Leo now knew that he had to prove himself as much as he had to show Max and Nolan that he could face and defeat the gauntlet. He knew this was his opportunity to succeed in a way he'd always envisioned for himself. Oh, well, I might as well get started, he thought to himself. As the saying goes, today is the first day of the rest of your life. Can you imagine for a moment that you're just taken somewhere with and only given $20 in the most expensive city in the world, okay? And just dumped there. Where are you going to live? What food? And you just got to rely on your wits. That's what happens to this poor fellow. Leo slowly stepped out of the luxury vehicle in the throng of New Yorkers. Amazingly, no one seemed to pay attention to him or to notice the car. He realized that all he had heard about New Yorkers was true. They were always moving and talking fast. This was, after all, the Big Apple, and limos were a dime a dozen in the city of success. Max was right as usual. Leo was famished. So he went across the street to the pizzeria, just as Max had recommended, and ordered a plain slice and an orange drink. He sat down at the counter, pondering just what he was going to do. Here he was in New York City, all alone, with next to nothing in money, and yet a self-made millionaire and a successful co-worker felt that he was ready to succeed. The steaming slice of cheese on a thin crust wrapped in a sheet of wax paper was served to him with an orange drink in a simple paper cup. Wow, $3.50 of his $20 was gone. Leo knew that his remaining meager funds would not go far in a city where he guessed hotel rooms started at $350. They're even more now since I've written this book, by the way. The pizza was way too hot to eat, but Leo was too hungry to care. Max was right. The pizza was the best he had ever tasted. Even if he did burn the roof of his mouth, the cheese was soft and chewy against the thin, crunchy New York-style crust. I was hungry when I wrote this. Leo believed that he could live on pizza alone. You can if you're a New Yorker, by the way. It was time to get down to brass tacks, so he took a pen from his pocket and began to write down some thoughts on a napkin, which he had removed from the dispenser. Leo knew that he had to set some priorities and make a sales strategy plan if he was going to survive, much less pass the gauntlet. Oh, well, time to get down to business. He needed to generate some money fast if he was going to be able to continue eating. There was also a problem of where he was going to sleep tonight. But he'd have to think about that later. All of a sudden, there was a loud, animated conversation coming from the table across the counter where Leo was seated. Look, Charlie, you can't just leave me like this. You know we're having the big promotion this month. If we don't sell our quota of cars, we will lose our allotment and priority status with the corporation, not to mention our discount. Hey, Herman, came the reply. Sorry about the short notice, but a fella's got to make a living. The guys over at Broadway Auto offered me my own office and more money per car. Trying hard not to stare, Leo noticed that the two men shook hands and the fellow called Charlie, who was quitting, abruptly got up and left. Leo saw that the man who appeared to be the boss sat shaking his head as if in deep thought. Leo got an idea and figured that he'd better do something or he was going to sleep on a park bench in Central Park tonight. With great trepidation, Leo got up and approached the man at the table. It was time for a patented Max, that was his mentor, guts move. Excuse me for interrupting you, sir. I know this is none of my business, but I may have a solution to your problem. Who the hell are you, bud? Herman barked. Leo immediately thought to himself that he was definitely in the Big Apple and that his idea wasn't going to go to be an easy sell. Well, sir, my name is Leo Silver, and I couldn't help but overhear your conversation. I just thought that I might have a solution for you. If you want to hear me out, otherwise I'll go back to where I was sitting. Go ahead, kid, pull up a chair, but make it snappy. I ain't got all day. Well, sir, I couldn't help but overhear you with the other gentleman before. You do need a new car salesman, and I think we may be able to solve each other's dilemma. Kid, I like your moxie, but have you ever sold cars before? Nope, came Leo's quick reply. Just widgets. The only thing I know about cars is how to drive them, but I have had some specialized sales training from my mentor Max, and I do have a sales background. I have everything I need to know how to become successful in any sales profession. I have a gut sales method. I don't have a resume of fantastic testimonials selling cars, but I am willing to make you the following offer. And I'll just interrupt here right now. Part of the gut sales method is to be assertive, be aggressive, act highly confident, even if you're scared shitless inside, and always make offers. You can always fix them later. But when you make an offer in the first meeting, the first phone call, people pay attention. They listen. What's the worst they can say? No? Back to the book. You have the right to say yes or no to me as long as you don't tell me you need to think about it. Can we agree on that one point before I make you my proposition? Sure, kid, go for it. Leo took a deep breath and was beginning to feel like he would soak his shirt. Here's my proposition. If I can sell a car by closing time this evening, you have to give me a job and a cash advance on my sale. Sounds good, kid, but what if you don't make a sale? Leo responded so quickly he surprised himself. If I don't, then I'll come back tomorrow and wash and wax every car in your showroom floor for free and leave with no questions asked. Either way, you win, sir. I don't know, kid. This is a pretty strange way to hire someone in a pizza place of all. Look, sir, Leo interrupted. You have a problem. You need salespeople to show and sell cars. Didn't I hear you correctly before say that you will lose your allotment and discount unless some cars go down the road today? Do we have a deal, or should I stop wasting our time and stop talking to you and start talking to your competition? I need a job and I need one today. Leo had a moment where he felt a rush of passion, power, and assertiveness that he wasn't aware he was capable of feeling. He knew he had just made a yes or no guts move, just like Max had shown him. He had to make the deal work fast or find something else. He held his breath as he watched the brown eyes of a man named Herman and awaited his decision. Herman took a deep breath as he began weighing the situation. On one hand, he had just lost his best salesman. On the other hand, he had this strange kid who seemed to really want the job. All this weird talk about guts, mentors, and such. Oh, well, he figured, what did he have to lose? Business was slow that day anyway. Okay, bud, I'm a gambling man. You have the rest of the day to sell a car. You make a sale, you got a job, you know? And in advance. But no sale, we owe you nothing, and I get my cars washed gratis. He held out his hand. My name is Herman, and I'm the sales manager for Grand Motors here in the city. You have 10 hours before we close for the day. By the way, what did you say your name was? And that is the challenge for Leo. Leo is our poor, sad sack guy. He's broke. He's stressed out. He's always thinking and worrying about money. He had a job in the beginning of the book, if you read it, with the world's worst sales manager. And he met this man called Max the Mentor. This is based on my story, basically. This is fiction. It's a novel. But I met a man named Max, and he was the greatest salesperson I ever met. And my life, I know exactly the moment my fortunes, my prosperity, my wealth changed. I know when my life changed, that exact aha moment when I met the world's greatest salesperson. And because I met this person, everything in my life changed. I stopped being the shy, reluctant, kind of, you know, poor me kind of guy. And I became a confident salesperson. I spoke to more people. I made more offers. I had an actual step-by-step system to make it all work. And my life changed at that very moment. I thought it was all the other stuff, the busy work, the applications, all the seminars, all the information and everything. Really, it was about communication. And I think in our society today, maybe it's all the digital information on the automation and the artificial intelligence and everything. We have forgot that in the end, it's usually communicating to one person, maybe two, and getting a decision made. And we've lost that ability to communicate it to our benefit. And so I wrote this book And forgive me, I think it's the world's greatest sales business novel. I've read all the sales books. I have hundreds of sales books. And most of them, they kind of say the same thing. Ask for the order, knock on 100 doors, give the presentation. They say the same old tired stuff. But we're in a society today where people, they've heard it all before. They just want someone who brings value, who they can like and trust, and who sounds completely different. And when you sound different, which is the essence of the guts sales method, it basically, people pay attention to you. And guess what happens? When you talk to a few people every day and they pay attention, you get people saying yes a lot more often and you make a lot more money. My name is Claude Diamond, and this is The Mentor Teaches the Gut Sales Method. I think it's the world's greatest sales and success business novel. And if you click the link in the description or below the video, you can learn more about this book and the package that I have with it. Thanks for putting up with me and listening to this. But remember, sales is the million-dollar skill. Take my word for it. And nobody deserves success more than you good people. Thank you.